The fact that gays and lesbians worked and lived in Hollywood was an industry secret, a secret that could no longer be contained with the coming of AIDS.
It was Rock Hudson who put AIDS on the map as an international story. There's no doubt about that. Of course, he did everything in his power to deny he had it, embittering everyone who knew him. You know, right to the, even his closest friends and lovers don't feel that he behaved ethically at the end about it.
There was a time with Rock Hudson, nobody talked about AIDS. It was very prevalent back then, but nobody talked about it. His death, his untimely death, brought it about where people could talk about it.
Rock Hudson adored women. He had so many women friends. He was a lovely man that he had to deny to his dying day. How he really felt about the world is, I find that very sad.
Un estudiante de musicología llamado Mark Christian. Christian tenía 29 años, casi la mitad que Hudson. Mark físicamente era el tipo de Rock. Era igual que una muñeca. No podía haber encontrado a un hombre más alto, guapo, rubio, esbelto y escultural. En 1983, Mark Christian se convirtió en una presencia permanente en el castillo de Rock. El 5 de noviembre de ese año se mudó a la casa de Hudson. Los amigos de Rock desconfiaban de las razones de Christian.
Mark Christian es un capítulo muy triste en la vida de Rock. Personalmente no creo que a Mark le preocupara en absoluto Rock, aparte de por ser una gran estrella de cine.
Cuando Rock Hudson regresó de París, su relación con Mark Christian empezó a deteriorarse. Hasta hoy, todavía queda la duda sobre cuánto, si fue algo, le contó Rock a Mark sobre su enfermedad.
Me dijo que estaba preocupado por la gente con la que había mantenido relaciones y que les había enviado cartas diciéndoles que tenía SIDA y también aconsejándoles que fuesen al médico.
El biógrafo de Hudson, Jerry Oppenheimer, no cree que Christian supiera nada de la enfermedad de Hudson.
Rock Hudson puso su vida en peligro porque en aquel momento todavía continuaban con su relación. Mark le preguntó a Rock si tenía cáncer o le pasaba algo. Y Rock solo le dijo, no, estoy a dieta.
Nunca diría que Rock Hudson quisiera intencionadamente ver muerto a Mark Christian. Pero su actitud, al no decirle nada, fue la de utilizarle para su propio placer. Utilizó a Mark en su provecho, en un momento en que estaba infectado por el virus del SIDA.
Sin embargo, la paz no duraría mucho tiempo. El 2 de noviembre, justamente un mes después de la muerte de Hudson, su exnovio Mark Christian reclamó 14 millones de dólares del patrimonio del actor en el Tribunal Superior de Justicia de Los Ángeles. Alegaba que el actor le ocultó su enfermedad durante el periodo que mantuvieron relaciones.
En primer lugar, Rock Hudson era un actor muy popular. La gente no quería creer que le hubiera ocurrido algo así. Sentían lástima por él.
A su vez, los representantes de Rock Hudson devolvieron la acusación a Christian por extorsionar a Rock a cambio de no revelar el secreto de la homosexualidad del actor. El juicio se prolongó más de 3 años, y el jurado escuchó repetidas alegaciones de la irresponsabilidad de Hudson y de la promiscuidad de Christian. Finalmente, el 15 de febrero de 1989, el jurado resolvió con un veredicto de 14 millones y medio para Christian de 35 años. 3 días después, los daños y perjuicios elevaron la cantidad a una cifra sin precedentes, cerca de 22 millones de dólares.
No sabíamos cómo reaccionaría el jurado. Por lo visto, reaccionó con la misma rabia y emoción que alguien que, sin saber la verdad, sigue manteniendo relaciones con una persona que tiene SIDA.
2 meses después, un juez del Tribunal Supremo de Los Ángeles, considerando que el jurado se había excedido, redujo drásticamente la compensación de Christian a 5,5 millones de dólares. Hasta hoy, Mark Christian sigue sin manifestar anticuerpos de la enfermedad mortal. La imagen y la reputación de Rock pueden haber sufrido durante el proceso de Mark Christian.
Poco después, en noviembre de 1983, un hombre de 29 años llamado Mark Christian se fue a vivir con Rock. Pero el amigo y publicista de Rock, Rupert Allen, dice que fue una aventura breve que se complicó.
Rock le tenía mucho miedo porque Mark Christian le dijo que conocía a los directores del Enquirer. y que le habían ofrecido mucho dinero si él, Mark Christian, les contaba la historia de la homosexualidad de Rock. Si lo hacía, Rock no volvería a trabajar como protagonista de una película. A Rock eso le aterraba.
Rock no llegó a echar a Christian de su casa ni a salir en su defensa. Pese a... Al cabo de un mes, Mark Christian exigió el patrimonio de Hudson, aduciendo que Rock le había expuesto conscientemente al virus del SIDA. Los abogados de Hudson contestaron que la relación sexual había concluido antes de que Hudson diese positivo en la prueba del VIH. En el momento de la demanda, Christian no era seropositivo. Un jurado le concedió 14 millones de euros de los 22 que constituían el patrimonio de Rock por angustia emocional. Los abogados de Hudson apelaron y un juez redujo la indemnización a 5 millones. Los repetidos mensajes telefónicos a Christian solicitándole una entrevista para este documental no han recibido respuesta.
Любовник подал в суд на наследников Хадсона. Люди хотели знать все подробности. Неужели Рок Хадсон подверг здоровье Марка Кристиана опасности? Что там произошло на самом деле? С одной стороны, нехорошо подавать в суд на больного СПИДом или на его наследников. С другой стороны, гомосексуалисты не желали выносить свою личную жизнь на всеобщее обозрение. Это моя личная жизнь, и я не обязан рассказывать о том, что я ВИЧ. Суду впервые пришлось решать, обязан ли по закону больной СПИДом извещать своего партнера о диагнозе. Главной идеей иска стала обязанность извещать партнера о своем ВИЧ-статусе. Это всколыхнуло все гей-сообщество. Был подан против умершего ответчика. Он не мог защищаться. Сначала мне не понравилось то, что иск был подан против умершего ответчика. Он не мог защищаться. Рок Хадсон. Это была знаком. У него так и не обнаружили ни ВИЧ, ни СПИД. Его друзья утверждают, что он с любовью отзывался о Рокке до конца своих дней. Он не захотел оставаться в Голливуде и продолжать шумный процесс.
The case has finally landed in court after several years of legal wrangling. Christian claims he first learned that Hudson had AIDS only after it was made public. Christian says he was shocked to find out the man he shared a bed with for 2 years had been privately diagnosed with the disease a year earlier.
Let the record show the jury is properly seated in the jury box and counsel and the parties are present.
In an $11 million court battle that got underway this week, it is Christian's contention that Hudson and others knowingly withheld the diagnosis from him, a decision that put his very life at risk. In his attorney's opening remarks, the graphic nature of the relationship with Hudson was described.
I've got to be blunt in talking about it. Alternating anal intercourse between the two men. Neither one used a condom.
Although Christian, now 34, concedes that he currently does not have AIDS, he fears it may develop later, and he claims he has suffered emotional distress because of it. He once elaborated on that aspect of the case during an appearance on The Donahue Show.
This is the way I feel about it. Whether or not I come down with AIDS, if I come down with it, it's even more tragic. But I think a person has a duty to disclose to the people they are with that they have a disease like that.
Action, obviously, the jury awarded Mark Christian $14.5 million, much more than the $11 million he was asking in his lawsuit against Hudson's estate and the actor's former secretary, Mark Miller. The suit claims Hudson and Miller conspired to keep the actor's disease a secret so that Hudson could continue to have sex with Mark Christian. The jury ruled that Christian suffered emotional distress because he wasn't told about the actor's condition. Christian has tested negative for exposure to the AIDS virus.
Mark Christian claimed he had high-risk sex with Rock Hudson 160 times, about 3 to 5 times a week, between June of 1984 and February of 1985, when he claims the romantic relationship ended. He claims the actor never told him he had the AIDS virus, and neither did anybody else. The 7-woman, 5-man jury concluded it was outrageous conduct for Hudson to keep his disease a secret from his lover, and awarded Christian $14.5 million, $3.5 million more than he asked for. Gay rights advocates in San Francisco say the jury sent the wrong message. Christian filed suit in November of 1985, a month after Hudson died of AIDS at the age of 59. A popular leading man in the movies, Hudson never acknowledged publicly that he was gay. Though Christian has repeatedly tested negative for the AIDS virus, he contends since he discovered Hudson had the disease, he has lived with an even greater fear of contracting AIDS. The jury found that Hudson's secretary and personal friend for more than 30 years, Mark Miller, knew Hudson had the virus, but conspired to keep the information from Hudson's lover so they could continue to have unsafe sex.
When Mark Christian walked out of court with a judgment of almost $22 million, many of Rock Hudson's friends simply couldn't believe it.
Since this started, I've had several friends who have died of AIDS, others who have become ill. To my knowledge, not one of them acted in the way that Rock Hudson acted.
Some critics believe the verdicts will encourage unsafe sex. Christian says times have changed.
I hope that nobody would be as naive as I was in 1982 or 83 and 1989.
Christian says he doesn't expect any money for 3 years, that he'll give some of it to AIDS charities, and that in the time between, he plans to get a job. In San Francisco, Wayne Friedman, News Center 4.
You can Rock Hudson, right?
Yeah.
Why is that? I'm a little bit naive when it comes to that.
Because he had AIDS and continued to sleep with me and wouldn't tell me.
Can I ask you, was Rock Hudson hung like a safety pin?
No.
Not at all?
Not a safety pin, no.
Who do you think got hit with more balls? Yogi Berra or Rock Hudson?
Rock Hudson.
Well, he would know, wouldn't he?
Who do you think? He was calculating. You see how he, you know, looked up for a moment and his tongue was going?
He's
he
like,
was calculating.
Who got, he's like a philosopher. Who got hit with more balls in the face? Rock Hudson or Yogi Berra? Now let's see. I know my baseball. Yogi must have been in how many games? He had a pretty long season. Probably like 15 balls in the face. Rock, I know for a fact, at least when he was with me, he got hit like 97 times in the face with balls.
With me alone.
Yeah,
he got
right.
hit with more balls. He's probably big.
Now let's see. With me, that means 97 times two.
I was very impressed that he didn't have to use his fingers.
Yeah, he's really going for it.
Maybe in 15 years.
Okay, then. Listen, thanks a lot, Mark. Okay.
Hopefully, if the tests are becoming a lot more accurate, I do think maybe there's a future in that. The main thing was getting through the 6 years of the legal process, which is interminably slow, but it finally did come to a good outcome. It's almost over. They still can appeal to the state Supreme Court, but it's up to them whether they want to or not, and it doesn't look good for them. We found out in trial that Hudson not only didn't tell me he had AIDS, he didn't tell me he had herpes. Hmm. Fortunately, I've never had an outbreak of herpes, but it just went along showing that The Secretary Mark Miller and Rock Hudson himself were just filled with nothing but lies throughout the whole legal process. I have several charities and other organizations in mind, and my goal is to set up a foundation that would oversee the giving to certain, basically, people that need the money. There are a lot of organizations, and I know they need money too, but they're actual people with AIDS who don't have housing or clothing or food, and there are certain projects like Project Angel Food, which I think is a direct helpline to these people. And I've got some ideas I'd like to try.
We dated for 9 months before we did anything together, and I knew him a year before I moved in.
Now,
so we were friends, basically.
Explain this. Since then, 1985, no one came out of the closet. Mm-hmm. How did Rock Hudson date?
He would come over at lunchtime. I'd come back from work, and we got to lunch. He never seemed to be uptight about it in public, but we didn't do a lot of physical, you know, affection or anything.
And but I was you go out aware. To dinner together?
Oh yeah.
And he and no one printed that in columns.
No,
and stuff
no. The press was very, very genteel 20 years ago compared to today.
So, and he had been married.
He had been married, and he did like women as well.
When he was with you, did he also see women?
No, not at that time.
But he liked women.
Oh yeah, very much so.
То, что в Голливуде работают лесбиянки и геи, держали в секрете. Но когда появился СПИД, секрет пришлось раскрыть. Из-за Рока Хадсона СПИД получил международную огласку. Это несомненно. Разумеется, он изо всех сил отрицал тот факт, что болен СПИДом. Он злился на всех своих знакомых, даже ближайшие друзья и любовники считают, что в конце жизни он вел себя неэтично. Был период, когда с Роком Хадсоном нельзя было говорить о СПИДе. Он был уже очень болен, но никто не говорил о болезни. Патрисия Шип, журналист. Его преждевременная смерть заставила людей заговорить об этом. Рок Хадсон обожал женщин, у него было немало подруг. Он был замечательным человеком. До самой смерти ему приходилось скрывать от людей свои истинные чувства. Мне кажется, это очень грустно.